Ladies and gentlemen, your chair judge for this match is Julie Shumley from Norway.
Well, if you're just logging on, great to have you with us here in Hobart. We're live from the Domain Tennis Centre. Day two action for 2015. We've just seen a tight three-set battle. Camilla Giorgi of Italy defeating Storm Sanders of Australia in three sets. It went to a tiebreaker. And coming up in just a few moments, it's going to be Roberta Vinci and Olivia Rogoska.
Launceston International, then followed it up with two doubles titles again in Launceston. She's currently ranked number 124 in the world, Olivia Rogoska.
Yeah, like for Storm Sanders, a big opportunity here for Olivia. It was so close in 2014 to cracking out the top 100. To a high of 102, currently sitting at 124 in the world, and just trying to take that next step. Beautiful tennis day once again, 24. We've reached the top of 21 so far, so edging a little bit closer to our maximum. Nice little breeze coming through as well. Great day to get out and watch the tennis. Olivia starting her week in Brisbane last week. She lost in the first round of qualifying. Won two ITF singles titles, which were fairly significant. She spent a lot of time in the United States training and basing herself. Not coming back to really play the Australian Pro Tour. Wanted to test herself against some world opponents who have risen up the rankings and won a couple of ITF singles titles, a couple of the big $50,000 events, one of those in Sacramento. And just trying to take that form now onto the WTA Tour. Only reached the second round just twice in 2014 in terms of WTA Tour events and six first round exits. Of course, it was announced a couple of days ago that she has already secured a wild card into the Australian Open. Saw her recently at the Australian Open wild card playoff at Melbourne Park. Didn't quite make it all the way through. Of course, she was the top seed. Think about Roberta Vinci, we think about Fed Cup, a great success with Sara Errani. Carved out a pretty respectable singles career as well. Lost in Auckland in the first round last week to start the year, but inside the world's top 50. Well, she did have a drop in her ranking, having got inside the top 20 at the end of 2013.
1 minute.
She's won nine career singles titles, but also she's won 24 doubles titles, and 21 of those with Sara Errani. And they've been a big factor in helping Italy win a number of Fed Cup titles over the years. So the last match proves that ranking can sometimes mean very little. Camilla Giorgi takes three sets over 2.25 hours. Tiebreaker in the third at 33 in the world to defeat the 365th player in the world in Storm Sanders.
Roberta Vinci on the toss.
So Vinci to serve to get us underway in this first round match. So a good hold for Vinci to get us underway. You're on centre court in Hobart. To follow, Karen Knapp, the other Italian playing today, taking on Isla Tomljanovic. Casey Dellacqua up against Lauren Davis. A little bit later on this afternoon, Davis a tricky opponent for Casey in the first round, looking to get her first victory of the year. And tonight, of course, Daniela Hunter-Kova, the former world number five. First time for her here in Hobart. She's got Carlos Rodriguez, well-known tennis coach, a couple of champions in Justine Enner and also Lina in her corner now for 2015. Very near misses here for Olivia. One out wide and one down the tee. Good serve. Great serve. One area she's certainly been trying to improve on in the last 12 months. Just put a little bit more venom into that serve and try and get some free points. So the serve a couple of times has been able to get her out of trouble. She'll need her best here. She's given away her service game, so Roberta Vinci off to a good start here with the breaker serve. She leads it 2-0. Rankings points separating this pair. Vinci, 8 years the senior. Very experienced campaigner, Roberta Vinci. Won a lot of matches in her career. Little opportunity here for Olivia Rogoski with a break point. Third game, Rogoska works her way back. Still Vinci with the break, leading it 2-1. On a fine day here in the Tasmanian capital. And good crowds continuing to pour in. If you're just joining us for the first time, Camilla Giorgi, the Italian, in a match that went around the 2.25-hour mark. She defeated Australia Storm Sanders to win her way through to the second round of the meeting with Kaya Kanepi. Alison Risk of the United States also winning today. Her opponent, Christina McHale, having to pull out of that match after losing the first set 6-4. Anika Beck of Germany also through to the second round. She won in 3, 6-4 in the third up against Sipilova of Slovakia. And Bojana Jovanovski of Serbia has got through her opponent, Mirjana Lucic-Baroni of Croatia, having to retire from their match early. Jovanovski was leading that match 5-2. So two withdrawals due to injury today. So Alison Risk will play Bojana Jovanovski in the second round here in Hobart. Seeing variety, but gee, she was hitting the ball well in that point. Rogoska. So now 3 break points. For Roberto Vinci. So the break back for the Italian, and she leads it 3-1. Once again, another good first serve there from Rogoska, but the unforced error coming off the ground. Winner of this match will take on Anika Beck, Germany. Miss too many balls, Vinci. Very solid. I think spectacular. Taking advantage of the second serve. That's what she's got to do, Olivia, when she's got her window. It's been a big emphasis in the last 12 months to certainly improve that serve and a bit heavier off the ground. She's going to match it the better players. Great serve. good start here for Roberto Vinci. Hashtag Hobart Tennis, get involved in the conversation. Follow all the action here this week from the Tasmanian capital. HobartInternational.com.au is the website. All the scores of the day, all the news, all the images just keep coming back. On the order of play. The Italians certainly having the upper hand on the Australians so far today here in Hobart. Yeah, good power off the ground. Too much heat from Roberto Vinci. Some good power. So all one-way traffic at the moment. Some work to do for Olivia Rogoska. Getting a wild card into Hobart, but not matching the experience of Roberto Vinci at the moment. Brings up three set points. Yeah, it's long from Rogoska, so yeah. Vinci. In the blink of an eye here, 6-1 opening set. Women's first round action. here from the Domain Tennis Centre in Hobart. Magnificent day for tennis, 24 degrees we're heading for. It's a tough battle and a great fight shown by Storm Sanders from an Australian perspective earlier. Going down in three sets, but for Olivia Rogoska, some thinking to do at the sit down. Just not able to dictate any part of that opening set, serving the one double fault. Vinci rock solid on the serve. 76% of her first serves going in. So just getting the ball into play. Really the story of the tape at the moment, and just generating a lot more power off the ground. And a staggering stat there, winning 80% of her points on the second serve. Olivia Rogoska, just 14%.
Fine.
27 points to 12 she won, so dominated the Italian.
Thank you.
So Vinci able to break in the opening service game of the second set. Just not happening for Olivia Rogoska out here.
Well, boys, throw a towel back there somewhere. Thank you.
Really needs to take a few risks here, Olivia, and just start to swing. She can't play conservatively, which is doing her no favours at the moment. That's much better. Good dip. It's a good first serve percentage. It's 76% in that opening set. Well, she's just got to open the shoulders up here, Olivia, and try and get Vinci moving, put her into some uncomfortable areas. Now break point. It's great work from Olivia Rogoska to get the break back and just get a little bit of confidence. Right on the line. Break of serve, not uncommon in women's tennis. This year perhaps Serena Williams. Thank you. So the break given back. We saw it in the last match in that third set tiebreaker between Storm Sanders and Camilla Giorgi. And happening here in this one. But, Roberta Vinci in control, 6-1 and 2-1 with the break here in the second round. Great day to be out in the bay. I think Roberta Vinci is keen to maybe get out in the water. She's in a hurry here. 6-1, 2-1 with the break in this second set. So a second chance in this set for Rogoska to break serve. Long call against Da Vinci. Rogoska gets the breaker serve for a second time. They're looking to capitalise on that break. Just broken to love in her last service game. Up next, it's going to be Karen Knapp of Italy to take on Isla Tomljanović of Croatia. These days, of course, residing in Brisbane and seeking full citizenship here in Australia. One of the players on the move up the rankings. There's a catch. Well done, sir. Takes a bow. Able to generate a little bit more power here, Olivia Rogoska, and that's going to be the key for her if she's going to stay with Vinci here and possibly force it to a third set. She served the three aces so far, Vinci. None for Rogoska, but Rogoska has served the three double faults so far in this match. First serve percentage quite similar. Vinci at 64%, Rogoska at 58%. You can join the conversation, hashtag Hobart Tennis. Right throughout the afternoon into tonight, our night session starts. And better on serve overall, Vinci at 67% on the first serve, just 47% for Olivia Rogoska, and only winning still 14% of her second serves. But she leads the scoreboard in this second set, 3-2.
Thank you.
So a quick hold here by the Italian. She gets it back to 3-all. Great shot. Shot the day so far from Olivia Rogoska. Game point here for 4-3, generating some more power. A couple of good clean winners in this match. So we've seen a couple of double faults. So Olivia Rogoska has her nose in front in this second set. Was blown away in the opening set, 6-1.
Oh.
is a pretty pivotal year for Olivia at 23, been on the tour now for quite some time, trying to break that top 100 for the first time in her career. Got so close at 102. She has a wild card already into the Australian Open starting next Monday. Enjoyed a bit of success at ITF level at the $50,000 events in 2014, but trying to transfer that now against some better players on the WTA Tour. Just needs to be able to generate some power. A lot of good depth, a lot of good young players inside the top 100 in women's tennis, and it's a tough one to crack. Saw a player like Camilla Giorgi a little bit earlier, the same age as Olivia, and ranked about 90 spots higher. Just the power she was generating.
Please.
There's a quick reply from Roberta Vinci, holding to love on serve. Comes a huge ninth game here for Rogoska. Already a set down. And you feel if she gets broken here, that might just break the back of the Australian.
Thank you.
certainly showing she can generate some power from the back of the court. Olivia Rogoska, and trying to do that repetitively. It's an important hold. 5-4. Can she force it to a third? That question to be answered in just a few moments here at the Domain Tennis Centre in Hobart. Great to have you along on this Monday afternoon. Building up to the 2015 Australian Open to start in a week's time at Melbourne Park. And it's been a great honour roll here in Hobart over the last 21 years. 21 different winners of the tournament. Well, the players in the draw this year, Mona Barthel is back, who won it back here in 2013. Was the runner-up in 2012, I should say, and was the runner-up in 2013. A couple of those live matches going on, round one action on the outside courts. Kirsten Flipkins of Belgium taking on Katerina Kozlova of the Ukraine, who got through qualifying. It is Flipkins about to serve for the opening set, leading 5-4. And Sei Sei Zheng of China taking on the qualifier, Joanna Larsson. Zheng leading at 4-3. In the opening set of that one. Fair rally. Bit of fight here in Olivia. Serena Diaz, the number two seed, has got through today in straight sets. Annika Beck of Germany. Points away. Bojana Chovanovski also through. Alison Risk through. And as we saw here on that centre court, Camilla Giorgi of Italy also through to the second round. So three set points now for the Australian. Rewind about 20 minutes ago, it didn't look likely. Yeah, well played by Olivia Rogoska. She's worked her way back here. Set a piece. Some good fight being shown by the Aussie. Still plenty of tennis to be played today. Karen Knapp of Italy to take on Ila Tomljanovic of Croatia. That game is coming your way next. Casey Delacqua to take on Lauren Davis. And tonight, from 7 o'clock, local time, Daniela Hunter-Kova taking on Richelle Hogenkamp of the Netherlands, who's got through qualifying here.
Sure.
Another qualifier, Madison Bringle, to be in action against the former champion here in Hobart, Mona Barthel, who's 41 in the world. And post winning here in Hobart in 2012, she's gone to win two other WTA Tour titles, one in 2013 and one in 2014. She won in Bastard over there in Sweden. So Vinci gets the break. First game of the third set. The last match is in the indication. It might just be a topsy-turvy decider. Kokoschka with a huge opportunity here. Vinci certainly early in the match, taking that first set 6-1. Looked to be unbeatable, but Kokoschka has shown some good fight to get back in here and just got to keep being aggressive. They try and step into the ball and take it early and dictate where the ball goes. They've got those great hands. One of the best doubles players going around, Roberto Vinci.
14.
So Vinci with a good hold and a good start to this decider. Two games to love. The winner of this match to take on Annika Beck of Germany in the second round. Good hold. Three love would have been tough to come back from. Still Vinci with the break for a spot in the second round here in Hobart. Great to have you with us here from the Domain Tennis Centre. Hope you're enjoying our live coverage. Day and night sessions right throughout the week. The semi-finals to be played on Friday. The final here, Saturday afternoon. Hashtag Hobart Tennis if you want to join the conversation. The initial return back was terrific. That first strike on the ball, so important for Rogoska in returning serve. Need to get a good deep ball back. Put pressure on her opponent. Smart play by Vinci. Here for both players. Vinci to keep the break. Goska to level the score up and try and get her nose in front on serve in this deciding set. Thank you. from Rogoska. So important hold here for Roberta Vinci. She maintains the break 3-1. Feel one more break of the Rogoska serve and she might just be on her way to a berth in the second round here. Roberta comes into this tournament ranked 44 in the world. Olivia at 124. Two other matches live at the moment. Kirsten Flipkins, Katerina Kozlova of the Ukraine. Flipkins leading 1-0. Seizei Zing of China, 6-3 in the opener against Johanna Larsson of Sweden. It's a fine line. She's trying to go nice and deep. Just overcooked a couple. Needs to keep being aggressive, being assertive. Great stuff. Lovely. Constructed. Just a point at a time here for the Aussie. Cleared good. Olivia thinking going beyond the baseline. That was very close. An update around the courts. Joanna Larsson of Sweden has got through to the next round despite dropping the first set, but her opponent, Zhe Zhe Xing of China, has retired. So that's three retirements today in the first round. So first time in a while Rogoska's had the advantage. Kirsten Flipkins, 6-4, 2-all with Katerina Kozlova of the Ukraine. Live action. And Rogoska got there in the end. And stays alive in this third set. Still Vinci with the break. See the beautiful city of Hobart in the background. And, good crowds are continuing to file in, certainly in anticipation of seeing the top seed a little bit later on in Casey Delacqua. Every seat a good seat here at the Domain Tennis Centre, right on top of the action. Fine. And she's still maintaining this break. Slider out wide. Great angle. Yeah, short ball coming back. How to put that away comfortably. Very efficient on serve today, Vinci. Get to work overtime. Just to stay in the point originally. Gets a bit of reward. Vinci maintains her break. Last service game for Olivia Rogoska went around the 10-minute mark. It's tough going just to hold serve and stay alive in this match. Thank you. Hanging in, Olivia Rogoska. Still Vinci with the break. Around the courts live, first round action. Kirsten Flipkins 6-4, but trails 3-2 in the second up against Katerina Koslova of the Ukraine. Joanna Larson getting through, courtesy of her opponent, Zhe Xing retiring from China. The Chinese player won the first set 6-3. Larson led the second, one game to love, when Xing couldn't go on any further. And the other winners so far today, as we saw here on centre court, Camilla Giorgi, the Italian, in three sets over Storm Sanders. Alison Risk of the United States defeating fellow countrywoman Christina McHale. That was 6-4 in the first. Then McHale had to call it quits. Zarina Diaz of Kazakhstan, who is the number two seed here in Hobart, getting through in straight sets. Anika Beck in three sets. And Bojana Jovanovski of Serbia got through against Mirjana Lucic-Baroni of Croatia, who had to retire 5-2 down in the first set. Last service game she held to love Roberta to get to 5-3. Just about have a foot in the second round. Power by Vinci. Rogoska not able to make any inroads on the Vinci serve. think she came away from a spot in the second round. In the corner. So now a couple of match points for Roberta Vinci and a spot in the second round. Long from Rogoska, so it's 2-0 in favour of Italy over Australia today so far on this Monday here in Hobart. And Roberta Vinci clinches a berth in the second round. 6-1, 4-6, 6-3. She'll now take on Annika Beck of Germany in the second round. We'll hear from our winner courtside in just a moment. Don't go away because the next match will be coming your way very shortly. Karen Knapp of Italy taking on Ila Tomljanović of Croatia. That one coming up next here on Centre Court. Let's go courtside and hear from our winner, Roberta
Vinci. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our winner in the first round, Roberta Vinci. Roberta, tough match, got away pretty well, but Olivia fought back.
Yeah, of course. Tough match, tough condition. I played first set, good set, and then Olivia she played much better in the second and third. But I think it was not easy to play, a lot of wind, and first match here, so I just came yesterday from Auckland, so it was not easy, but of course I'm happy that I won.
Chilly conditions in Auckland, or?
No, of course it's a little bit of a jet lag, and then I played just double at the end of the week, so it was difficult, but I'm happy, you know.
And what do you think of Hobart so far? Is you playing here in Hobart and being around the city? What do you think?
Not yet, but of course, if I have time this afternoon, I will go to in the centre. Of course, it's nice weather, a little bit windy, but it's okay.
Tell us a bit about yourself. I mean, you do the tour. You're excellent in doubles, etc. But away from the tennis court, what does Roberta Vinci like to do?
Outside the court?
Outside of playing tennis, in what you do in your leisure time?
Nothing special. Go a little bit of shopping and sometimes go to the cinema. Nothing special.
And all shopping is always a priority for a woman, isn't it?
Yes. Why not?
And I guess being in Tasmania, you haven't seen much of it first. Have you heard much about it before you came here?
No. So
it's all in front of you?
Yeah, of course. So in 5 time I will go.
All right, put your hands together for Roberta Vinci, who's through to the second round of the Hobart International 2015.
So our next match, not too far away. The players will be out on court. Karen Knapp of Italy to take on Ila Tom Leonovic of Croatia. Knapp 53 in the world, and Tom Leonovic ranked at 63. And to follow that will be Casey Delacqua up against Lauren Davis. And the night session tonight, Michelle Hogenkamp, the qualifier from the Netherlands, to take on Daniela Hantikova, the former world number 5. And Madison Bringle has come through qualies as well to take on 2012 winner here in Hobart, Mona Barthel.